Greetings all, it's Devious Monkey here. I've been trapped in my office pretty much all day today, other than going grocery shopping. So I am way behind the eight ball here and getting shit done. I had to go for a walk though, because I've been sitting in my office all day. While I was out, I shot a video three times. The first two times, they just sucked, so I started over. The last one basically became a rant, and I'm gonna tell you what that's about real quick. I have been trying to do all this stuff and learn all these freaking cameras and lenses and flashes and programs and this is and that's. And it, like I said, it's been one step at a time. The big problem was that, you know, if I don't have anybody to shoot, I need to shoot myself. I'm perfectly fine with doing that, with the exception of, I couldn't do that. Why couldn't I do that? Well, because with this A7 R4, I tried to hook it up to the Sony imaging app and was horribly frustrated. It would absolutely not focus. All I could do was change the settings and I could fire off a shot, which didn't do me any damn good because I couldn't focus. It would not focus. So I spent a lot of this morning on the internets looking to find out what the hell's going on. And I found that like it just doesn't work that well. I also pulled out a remote that I had bought a while ago, and I couldn't get that to do anything other than fire the shutter, and that was it. I couldn't do anything else. So I looked that up and saw that it worked with a lot of cameras, but it didn't work with the A7 R4. And I'm thinking to myself, Jesus, here we go again. I buy a freaking flagship camera and the most basic things it can't do. So I was getting really pissed off. Now I remember, based on battery size, that I had bought a different style of remote at one point because I bought a shit ton of batteries for it, those little lithium ones that are like, you know, look like a quarter. I had a whole box of those, and I'm just thinking, well, on that other remote, that was the remote that I had, and I pulled the battery out thinking that I just needed a new battery because I haven't used it in a long time, and it was a different size, and I didn't have any of those batteries, and I was like, okay, what the hell? You know, and then you get in your head, and you're all pissy and stuff, and you're like, you remember seeing that remote pretty much everywhere, but you can't find it. I ended up realizing that the batteries that I bought a shitload of were for that Bluetooth grip that I had gotten to use with the A6600s and or the ZV1. Okay, great. So I pulled that out and I paired it to the A7 R4 and it would only fire the shutter. It would not focus. And I'm like, you have got to be kidding me. Come on. And I looked that up and then I'm like, okay, there's got to be a freaking remote that works like this, that the way I want it to work. So I started looking up videos and going through forums and all that kind of shit. And I saw a Sony Bluetooth remote, you know, like a long little, small little candy bar sized one. And because I was like, I don't want to bring that big ass Bluetooth grip with me just so that I can shoot a picture. Then it didn't matter because I couldn't get it to focus. Well, okay, so I find this Bluetooth remote, and it has different switches so that you can either focus or you can zoom and all that kind of stuff. And I was like, damn, that's another $80. But I need to do this. So I'm like, okay, let me look it up and see what people say about it on the internet. And I found another guy who suggested a JJC version of it that was only $28. I'm like, okay, and I read, it only had a couple of reviews, and they were like, you know, you get what you pay for, it's not that great, I don't know why people are saying it's that great. So I'm all frustrated. I've got a Sony remote, I've got a Sony Bluetooth grip, I've got Sony imaging app, and not a damn one of them work the way that I need them to work. And I'm just like, ugh. So I'm hangry, I still have work to do, I still gotta do the video, I still had to take a pic of the day. I was just sitting here trying to do something. I'm like, okay, I need to eat, it's getting too late. So I made my dinner, and I came up here and I sat down and I thought, all right, I can do the pic of the day. And I took a quick picture in my studio, and I was pulling it off of the card, and Lightroom failed, which happens every once in a while. It says it can't find the catalog, and I was like, God dang it. So I had to restart my computer after I shut everything off, get it going again, blah, 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 blah. I do the pick of the day, and all of a sudden, I have an epiphany. I'm thinking to myself, okay, the first thing I do when I use a still camera is I shut off the half-press shutter autofocus. I turn that off because I use back button focus. And then I set one of the buttons, usually the AEL or whatever the hell button that is right up there by my thumb. I set that to be the focus, the autofocus. And at this point now with the A7 R4, that's already set for focus, eye focus, and all that kind of stuff. So I checked all that earlier today, that I was getting the eye autofocus turned on correctly and all that stuff. But then it hit me. Maybe it's not working. Because something I saw in that video, that guy said something about pushing the shutter button, that you got to be really careful because it'll do a half-press shutter, and sometimes it doesn't take the picture. And I was thinking, you freaking idiot. Because you shut off the half-press shutter autofocus, that's why it's not autofocusing. Because you're back button focusing, so you have, it can't do it. And I was like, okay, if it's this simple and this was my fault, So I grab the Bluetooth grip, I go into the menu on the A7R4, and I turn on the half press shutter focus. And then I push on the button on the damn Bluetooth remote, and it works like a charm. And I'm like, I'm a freaking idiot. Okay, let's just see how bad this really is. Because, I mean, that entire video that I shot that I'm not using now was me freaking out and trashing the Sony imaging app again because it was such a piece of shit the last time I tried to use it, and now I can't even take a picture because I can't focus. I go in, I connect it, and I hold down over the shutter thing with my thumb. You know, I put my thumb on the screen, and the damn thing focuses. Okay, people, if you've watched any number of my videos, you've heard me say that sometimes I'm just a dumb monkey. Here's another instance of it. It's just like when I trashed the Insta360 One R because it kept shutting off, and I realized it was because I was saying the command words to shut it off, and then every time I turned it back on, I freaked out and was screaming about how this damn thing keeps shutting off, and then it would shut off. Same thing here. The A7R IV works with the damn Sony imaging mobile app if you're not doing back button focus. You have to do the half press shutter. And it also works with the Bluetooth grip if you don't have back button focus. That's the gist of this video, that I'm a complete dumbass again, and I figured it out. Now I can freaking take pictures of myself with the imaging app or the Bluetooth grip if I feel like it. But either way, it works. I'm a dumb monkey. Sorry. That's all I've got for you today. If you have any comments, leave them down below. As always, thanks for joining me. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.